A few weeks back, I collaborated on a digital invisibility shield project for Jake, who's from the popular YouTube channel Jay Laser Video. So this project required us to match the perspective of the viewer to the projected scene so that it gives the perception of invisibility. One method to solve this perspective mapping problem was by using computer vision to perform face detection. It was a pretty complex project, but what's not so complex is face detection, which is the topic of this video. We're going to be talking about what it is, how it works, and how to implement 70 plus frames per second face detection on a CPU, all in under 5 minutes. First up, what is face detection? Well, it's quite intuitive. Just detecting faces, right? Well, the more formal definition is that face detection is a technology that enables computers to identify human faces in digital images. It is a type of object class detection in which the task is to find the location and sizes of all objects in the image that belong to a given class. In this case, it is faces. So the reason why you'd be interested in using face detection is, as we mentioned earlier, is to, number one, find out how many faces you have in an image, two, the size of the face, which can also help us to determine how far the face is from the camera, and three, the location of the face within the image. Manipulating objects, both physical and or virtual, like in the case of the invisibility shield, is just one of the many applications of face detection. The other application is to get people to like and subscribe to this video. Haha, just kidding. Face detection is not to be confused with facial recognition, which is the process of identifying each individual rather than all faces just being the same. We'll cover recognition in a separate video. Moving on, there's a massive amount of ways in which we can implement face detection. Before deep learning, face detection used to be done using hard cascades. Eventually, it evolved using machine learning to do feature extraction with the histogram of oriented gradients, also known as HOG, and this was used in the DLib frontal face detector. Currently, using face detection can be implemented with a deep learning neural network, or DNN, using a ResNet-10 architecture. In our implementation, we'll be using BlazeFace, which is an ultra-fast face detection model that is both lightweight and accurate. In this tutorial, we'll be using the MediaPipe implementation of BlazeFace to achieve over 70 plus frames per second on a 720p video and on CPU. That's right, no need for an expensive CUDA-enabled GPU. Cool, so before we get into the tutorial, if you're just starting out in computer vision, the way to build computer vision apps is to use OpenCV. Right now, OpenCV have just launched a Kickstarter campaign for their brand new OpenCV for Beginners course. You can see from their page, they've already surpassed their goal and are backed by over 1,000 backers. So if you'd like to learn to build your own exciting computer vision applications with OpenCV and start your AI journey, then click the link down below. To enable this, go over to the Vision Store, click on Face Detection, ensure that you are logged in, otherwise you can sign up. Ensure that you have all of the requirements, in this case any PC, a webcam, as well as Python installed along with PyCharm Community Development Environment. Step 1, once PyCharm Community has been installed, create a new project and let's call it facedetection.py. You'll be required to install only two dependencies, OpenCV and MediaPipe. It's highly recommended to use the exact same versions mentioned here for compatibility with the code. And then lastly, you download the code, or you can copy and paste it here from the Vision model page. To run the code on a video, you just need to click the play button. To run this on a webcam, you can simply change the name of the file here to 0, and then you'll be able to detect faces using your webcam. Let's delve into the code to understand how it works on a high level. The first part, we import our libraries, especially OpenCV and MediaPipe. Next, we initiate our webcam or video, and then establish our face detection threshold, which adjusts the sensitivity of our detector. Next, we change our color space from BGR to RGB, which also stands for red, green, blue. Lastly, we search through all of our detections and draw a bounding box over the faces before displaying all of the information to a window. Simple, right? I'll show you how to modify this code in future for your own applications. For now, if you have enjoyed this 5-minute tutorial in computer vision, then check out more models on our Vision Store only on augmentedstartups.com. The Vision Store is where you can download and implement projects without wasting too much time, and is meant for rapid prototyping and quicker time to market. Otherwise, check out our comprehensive courses in computer vision, AI, and robotics. Also, be sure to like this video, subscribe with that bell icon so I can beat the YouTube algorithm and get to 100,000 subscribers. And then finally, comment on what you'd like for us to cover next. Thank you for watching, and we'll see you in the next lecture.